All over. Do I hear somebody over there? All right, yeah, get him the hell out of here, will you, please? Get him out of here. Throw him out. Yeah, you can get him out. Yeah, get him out. Get him the hell out of here. Get him out of here. Get out.
They say, I have the most loyal people. Did you ever see that? Where I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and I wouldn't lose any voters,
President,
okay?
Trump even had words of advice to law enforcement on how to handle these arrests.
Please don't be too nice. Like when you guys put somebody in the car and you're protecting their head, I said, you can take the hand away.
Late this afternoon, the Suffolk County Police Department issued a statement saying, we do not and will not tolerate roughing up prisoners.
So if you see somebody getting ready to throw a tomato, knock the crap out of them, would you? Seriously. Okay? Just knock the hell. I promise you, I will pay for the legal fees. I promise. I promise.
You don't encourage your mob to say, knock the crap out of them. And if you do, I'll protect you from legal ramifications. Especially after your crowd, your mob, has already attacked countless people. We've seen it on tape. By the way, when the black guy got thrown down at the Trump rally, one person was saying, light that motherfucker up.
I'm walking, and as I turned, as soon as I turned, he hit me. And I was like, I thought it was a punch, but as I look at the footage now, it was an elbow or like, but he hit me dead in my eye.
And that condones a sucker punch, though?
But I want to see. The man got carried away. Right. He was 78 years old.
You bet I liked it.
Yeah? What'd you like about it?
Hell out of that big mouth. Yes, he deserved it. The next time we see him, we might have to kill him. The next time we see him, we might have to kill him.
Trump is blaming Vice President Kamala Harris and Democrats for the apparent assassination attempt, saying their rhetoric is to blame.
And two people now have tried to kill Donald Trump in the last couple of months. I'd say that's pretty strong evidence that the left needs to tone down the rhetoric and needs to cut this crap out.
I've always condemned political violence. I always will in America. In America, we resolve our differences peacefully at the ballot box, not at the end of a gun. America suffered too many times the tragedy of an assassin's bullet.
The suspect believed the rhetoric of Biden and Harris, and he acted on it. Their rhetoric is causing me to be shot at. In last week's presidential debate, Mr. Trump appeared to blame Democrats for the first attempt on his life.
I probably took a bullet to the head because of the things that they say about me. They talk about democracy. I'm a threat to democracy.
Vice President Kamala Harris said in a statement, there is no place for political violence in our country. I've directed my team to continue to ensure that Secret Service has every resource, capability, and protective measure necessary to ensure the former president's safety.
Where I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and I wouldn't lose any voters.
President Trump even had